When it comes to optical transport, one of the biggest challenges is the attenuation. In other words, the loss of optical power. Now, there are many reasons for this, but the fiber cable in itself also introduces the optical loss. Now, the question is, what is it in the fiber that actually causes the attenuation? If you want to find out, and also how the advancement in fiber optic technology helped to drastically reduce the attenuation, stick around and we'll check it out. To understand where the attenuation of a fiber cable actually comes from, let's first have a look at this very simplistic setup. So on this one side, we've got the light source, in other words, we've got the laser, that emits a light which is passed through the fiber cable, and on the other side, obviously, we have the receiver. Now, the amplitude of the signal at the laser itself is as big as it gets. But if the signal travels through that fiber cable, something happens that leads to this amplitude continuously decreasing. Now, there are two main reasons for this to happen. The first reason being the so-called scattering. And what that means is that the light signal actually hits upon impurities and contaminations of the fiber cable, and some of that light signal actually is being scattered into various different directions. And that light signal being scattered is lost for the signal going forward. The other reason is the absorption. And basically what absorption is it's a conversion from one energy to another form of energy. In other words, that light signal, some of that light signal energy is being converted. And this is actually caused by alien atoms embedded within the fiber cable. So it can be metal atoms, but it can mainly also is hydroxide ions. Now, over the course of time, fiber technology as well as the production processes have increased drastically. And to show you how much I brought, as you can see here in this diagram. So on this side, we've got the optical loss per kilometer, so the attenuation. And here we have the grid ranging from 700 nanometers to 2000 nanometers. Here in the middle, we've got the ITU grid, in other words, our main transport window, where we've got CWDM and DWDM. Now, if we have a look at a fiber cable from the early 80s, you will see that we've got these two huge humps of attenuation, one at roughly 950 nanometers and the other one just shy of 1400 nanometers. And they were actually due to the hydroxide embedded within the fiber cable. And that's why they were also called the Waterpeaks. Now, over here, we also have the infrared absorption, but we can ignore that because that's outside of our transport window. Now, technology advanced, and even just having a look at a fiber cable from the late 80s, you will see that these water peaks are much smaller. As a matter of fact, here it's up to 4 dB per kilometer less absorption or less attenuation. Now, once again, it evolved and continued to evolve the fiber technology. And nowadays, we have got the low hydroxide fiber cables. And as you can see here, the attenuation, especially in that transport window, is extremely low. And also, we do not have those water peaks anymore. So, I hope you learned something today and that you enjoyed this video. If so, please leave a comment. Also, please let us know if there are any other topics that you would like us to cover. Once again, leave it in the comment. Okay, until next time, bye-bye.